So let's think about how we can compute homography. Let's start off my two images from my scene again. Again, this is the Lord's cricket ground. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to focus in on a specific region. Let's say this region here and this region here. The reason I'm actually picking these because there is a nice planar rectangle in that region, and we can actually use that as an example. Let's zoom these regions up. So we'll take this as one of our images, and the second one would be this one. And let's look at them a little bit more carefully. So here is my two regions, zoomed, and zoomed in a little bit of a left pan was done to kind of find this one. This is my equation. We know everything about it by now. What we're really interested in is computing a new p prime from using the transformation from the original p's. Let's find 4 points in this one. And I did say there was a reason I found this region, because now actually I can find 4 points at the corners of this sign that was on the grass. I can find the same 4 points here. So p prime would be here, p is here, right? So these are all xy's. And these would be, of course, in my new coordinate system, x prime, y prime, using just this equation of homogeneous coordinates. So again, all p's and all p primes. So to compute the homography, h here, given pairs of corresponding points in the two images, we need to set up a set of equations where the parameters of h are unknown. So in essence, this is my two sets. I can most probably get the information about where these locations are. What I actually don't know is what h would be between those two images, right? So that's what we want to compute. We want to actually model the transformation that goes from this to this. Because if I know this transformation, I can use this for a variety of things.